Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you very much. I've been trying to understand this for months. How do people make AI videos? Is it about the right tool? What prompts do they use? What's the secret? If you felt that too, you are not alone.
Let's find out together.
Now, but seriously, there are many questions to be answered here. How do people create videos using AI? How do people create the trending videos about tralalero tralala? What about the prompts? Are those easy to create? Are they crucial? Can you afford that? Is it expensive, cheap? How the hell can I create that? And there's also something else that nobody talks about, which is painful. And it's the fact that the AI is evolving very fast. So chances are that you can spend multiple hours learning how to use an AI tool to create videos. And in just a few weeks, there's gonna be a better tool, faster, cheaper, which means you might have wasted your time. So my biggest intention in this video is not to go and explain every single tool, because it's not going to age well. In just a few weeks, this video is gonna be useless. That's not what I want. I want to explain you a structure, a way of thinking about video generation using AI. So by the end of the video, you will feel confident. And then it's up to you what tool you'll use according to your needs, according to your budget, whenever you want. But when you want to do it, your life is gonna be much easier. Or at least your video generation life, if that's a thing. You understand what I'm saying, right? Okay, so let's break it down from the very beginning. Let's start
with... Can you also explain how to animate my beautiful face as well? Like this?
Okay, yes. We'll cover that too. There are different ways to create AI using video. The most direct, simple one is using an AI model. You give a text prompt and you have your video. Great. The problem is that you usually won't get your desired result in the first try, and it is very expensive. I mean, if you are not in the free trial, the prices might vary depending on the model, but probably you are going to spend $1 per 5-second clip. So if you want to create a 30, 60-second Instagram reel, TikTok, and I'm not even talking about a YouTube video, you're gonna spend hundreds of dollars if you go that way. Also, you won't have consistency in your videos or in your characters. This is definitely not what you want. So we need to explore different ways. Let's talk about the concept called text-to-image, which is very cheap, or actually free if you use ChatGPT or other tools. So it's basically using an AI model, you give a text prompt and you have an image. And then there is a third concept called image to video. You use an AI model, you give your image, which is going to be a frame in the video, it can be the first frame, the last frame, a frame in the middle, and you give a text prompt explaining what you want to happen in that video that will use that frame no matter what. This third option is very expensive as well, like the first one. But the fact that creating images is very cheap, or even free, allows you to do the iterative process, allows you to make all the mistakes in the image generation part. You can generate 15, 20, 25 images until you find the one that suits your needs. And once you have it, you go and generate the video only once. And probably in the first try, maybe in the second try, you're gonna have the clip you want. This, my friend, is the way everyone is creating videos using AI. Nobody is creating videos using prompts. What people do is creating images using prompts and then converting those images into videos. So feel free to skip this part if you're here for the conceptual explanation only, as I'll show practical creations later in the video. But right now, let's talk a little bit about the different AI tools. In this case, for image generation. So ChatGPT is one of the best ones because it's completely free and it has very good quality. But then there are other options that are paid, like Midjourney, which is probably the best one, Kria, that excels because it's really fast, and OpenArt, which I don't know much about it because I've never used it, I guess, but I think it has very good customization options from what I've seen. Going to video generation, we have to mention that Kling is the king right now. It is the very best model, the best quality, the best prompting accuracy. It's like the best, but it's very expensive. Every clip will cost $1 if you use the best model they have. Then you have Sora, which just don't use Sora. It's definitely not cool, but it comes with ChatGPT Plus, so you can give it a try. And I think it's good for transitions, like taking a video and transitioning to a new one. But I definitely don't recommend using Sora as your main video generation tool. Then there is Runway, which is the one I use the most. It is the second best if you ask me, and it is much cheaper than Kling. And if you pay the highest plan, like the most expensive plan they have, then you have unlimited generations for the entire month, which I think no other video generation tool has right now. Then there are other tools that I can't talk about because I don't have experience with, but from what I've seen, Haleiwa AI, Minimax, and Luma are very good for cinematic video. And then Pika has some additioning tools that, from my point of view, are much better than the other options. You can add characters, you can add props to a scene like no other model is capable of. There's something nobody mentions and I want to be clear with, which is prompt engineering. Prompt engineering is very important. Different AI models have, let's say, different preferences. So if you are using Runway to generate video, you need to define the type of shot, the type of movement, what the character is doing in a specific order. If you change the order, then probably the video generation is not going to be as accurate as you want. But other AIs for video generations might have other structures in their ideal prompts. And it is very important to do that well. But actually, you need to learn that. You can have good prompts by using ChatGPT. You can go to ChatGPT and say, hey, I'm using Runway for generating videos. I want a video of this. I want the character doing this. I want the video to look like this. Please give me the prompt. And ChatGPT will give you the prompt and you can just copy and paste it and that's it. You don't need to learn the structure of all the AI models. Or use whatever chatbot model you want, like Gemini or Llama or Claude, whatever you use. But the point is, you don't need to learn the prompt structure of every tool you use or you might drive crazy, especially considering the fact that everything is evolving so fast. So maybe a good prompt right now is not a good prompt in 2 or 3 months from now.
Let's now talk about how to animate a character's face.
So there's two things to have in mind. What you start with, which can be an image or a video, and how to drive it, which can be an audio or a driving video. Trust me on this one, it is actually very simple. Here are the four options that I've just mentioned. As I said, you can animate an image or a video using an audio file. This audio file will have the speech that you want your character to say, to reproduce. And then you can also animate images and videos, but using a video file instead, typically called driving video. This option will give you more accurate results because you use another video to control the face, the expression, the movements, where the eyes are looking at, the movements of the mouth, if the character is smiling or not. So here are some known tools for this purpose. Live Portrait has very good results and it's free. As long as you have the Python knowledge to run it on your PC, you're good to go with that one. But then you have Kling and Runway, which have something called lip syncing that allows you to animate images and videos with audio files. And then Runway particularly has the Act 1 feature, which allows you to animate your characters using driving videos. From my point of view, Runway Act 1 is the best one in terms of cost-benefits ratio. Text-to-speech is converting a text into an audio file of the voice of someone.
You should totally subscribe to Luciano Bruno's channel. It's pretty awesome.
And speech-to-speech is converting my own voice
into the voice of someone else, but keeping the breaths, keeping the laughs, keeping the silences, just like if it was me, the one
that is speaking. For both of these, there are different options out there. I personally use 11 Labs, which is paid, But the free trial, the free credits that they give you when you create your account can last a long time. So I would give it a shot. Okay, so now let's put everything together. I would like to create a video inspired by the Black Mirror Netflix series. So the concept is a futuristic company that can create or emulate conversations that are technically impossible. For example, allowing their customers to talk with their dead ancestors. Weird, but interesting, I guess. So to make a short out of this, I used ChatGPT a lot to craft some images and make the imagination process easier. I also crafted the script and the prompts for most of the images. For the image generation, I used Crea AI a lot, and also the construction of the main characters. And I didn't mention it, but Runway has a feature called Reference, which allows you to create images as well, not only videos. And it turned out to be very useful to put my characters in the desired locations with the clothes and the posture that I needed. Once I had all the images, just like I've explained in this video, I created the corresponding clips. I created the background music using Suno AI, and I created the necessary prompt using ChatGPT as well. And then I put everything together on DaVinci Resolve to have the final result. And that's the whole process. If you want, I can create another video that's probably gonna be much longer, going through every micro step of the process of creating a video using AI. But using all the things that I've just talked about in this video that you have just watched, you already understand the structure. You already understand the creation process. You already know the most important parts. Then it's just up to you to decide which tool you will use, depending on your needs and your budget. But you have everything to start with already. So here is the result.
Lost something? This song is restricted.
I am here to review the simulation 37A. It shouldn't be running.
So, you're the one they sent. Follow me then. Every simulation here is ethically approved, verified, and monitored. We don't allow autonomous behavior or unrequested replications. At least, not anymore.
Okay, I hope you liked the video. We can just finish here. But before you go, I want to give you a final message. At the end of the day, AI is not a storyteller. You are the storyteller. But AI will allow you to tell stories that you couldn't tell before, unless you were a millionaire or you had a big team or whatever, but now you can.
Hey, if you like this video, please subscribe. I'm going to be happy. Also, if you don't subscribe, the police is going to come for me.
No, no, la policía, no.